Next, we're going to get some practice tracing through Turing machine computations and programming Turing machines. The point of these exercises is not so that you can put on your resume that you're good at programming Turing machines. And if someone asks you in an interview to write a program to test, say, whether an input number is prime, I wouldn't recommend trying to draw a Turing machine state diagram. Somehow, I doubt that will land you the job. Rather, the point is to help you convince yourself that Turing machines can do everything that we mean by computation. And if you really had to, you could program a Turing machine to do anything you could write a procedure to do in your favorite programming language. There are two ways to convince yourself of this. One is to just practice so that you build up enough of a facility with programming Turing machines, that is to say, it just becomes easy enough for you, so that it seems intuitive that you could do anything. Another way to convince yourself of the power of Turing machines is to show that a Turing machine can simulate the action of models that are closer to real-world computers, like the random access model. We'll do that in a later lesson. But to be able to understand these simulation arguments, you need a pretty good facility with how Turing machines work anyway, so make the most of these examples and exercises.